All right, welcome everyone to the 30K video. Yasu, thank you for joining me today, man. Really excited to have you with us. A recent addition to, you know, the 30K CCL team, Lucio God himself, a very strong European Flinch player. How are you doing today, Yasu?
Hello, it's my pleasure to be there. I'm doing great.
Yasu, I'd love to hear your opinion on basically what are the pros and cons to Lucio as a, you know, support character? Like, where do you feel like his strengths are and where do you feel like his weaknesses are?
So the hero micro-wise can do like almost everything except I guess sailing your tank back to full HP, but that's really a struggle. The real issue is I guess the CC, but then you bring a lot of movement speed, so that kind of CC by itself, because if you go faster then it's as if the enemy would go slower. Mm-hmm. And you still have your trait and your boop, but the main problem is the PvE side. You can't do camps, you can't clear waves. But then again, this itself is balanced by you dismounting people every time and hitting them in rotation. So if the enemy doesn't PvE, then it's fine if you don't either.
Looking at the build for Lucio, could you run me through that of what talents you generally pick?
So level 1, you should always go accelerando, like no matter what. There is no reason to take anything else. It's literally plus 20% movement speed, like that's double your passive, which is the thing that makes Lucio good. Level 4, you would go, I mean, I guess the 3 talents you can take, but I prefer the CDR the most, because then you deal even more damage, you can cancel more spells. Like I used to run a lot of the quest boop, because when you use your trait to someone, like let's say a backlaner, you can boop him to your team. I think it doubles the distance almost, like plus 75%, so that's huge to get a kill. But it's not, it's the more of a side like getting kills and not dealing damage or not cancelling. So you're 7, you will go reverse amp 95% of the time. The other 5% that you don't take reverse amp is when you're up against Genji, because he would just kill you with the deflect. Either he kills you or you don't heal, like you're forced to stay in speed. But then if you're up against Genji, you take the shield on 7, which allows you to actually cock him and kill him if he tries to do anything.
Traditionally, you kind of have the standard like sound barrier build, but high five did get buffed. I'd love to hear kind of your thoughts about that, Yasu. What do you think about the high five changes? Do you think both ults are viable?
I mean, I think that high five before was really hard to use, because once you cleanse the target, you might die after it, essentially because you also lost accelerando. It's the level 1. So it increases your movement speed as you slide alongside a wall.
Yeah, it makes you lose your best mobility tools, kind of what you're saying.
Yeah, so the ult was kind of meh, but now you cleanse yourself, so it's kind of idiot-proof, if I might say.
So you're telling me even I could run it and you do well, you know?
Yeah. But the thing is, like, I think this ult should be taken in max 30% of the game.
Okay.
Because, like, what High Five does usually can be done with sound barrier, but in a better way. That allows you to engage with the whole team on top of it. Like, it soaks a lot of damage.
Yeah, so like because here's the thing. You're a high-level CCL player, right? You're one of the best Lucios in the world. You know, for the average person watching this video that's, you know, playing Lucio in their, you know, ARAMs, quick ganky, would you generally recommend that they would go that sound barrier then, just because it is easier to run? Or what would you say for that player?
I mean, the sad point is it's not easier to play, but it's way better overall. Unless you're up against like a Varian one-shot comp or some kind of stuff like that.
Gotcha. So it's basically sound barrier unless they have a specific blow up comp where you can just help again to save the one person that they're trying to kill.
If it's mass AoE CC or tank blow up or something, like you will go high five. But otherwise, you should mostly always go sound barrier because it's just way too good in team fights.
I love that. That's some really good insight.
13, the armor and speed when you go through an enemy is always super good. Level 16, I see a lot of players take Rejuvenescencia. I usually take the range and CDR on the E, because it means more damage because you have more range, and more damage because you will use reverse amp more often.
It's up the frequency is the one, right?
Yeah. Like, unless your fight lasts for only one E, which is really unlikely with Lucio, then yeah, maybe Rejuvenescencia is better, but up the frequency is just way too good as a talent.
And then what for 20 do you normally end up going?
So the 20 is actually weird on Lucio because everything is playable. It really depends on the game. If like sometimes you can't get sound barrier off because your carry gets one shot by, let's say, Zeratul, Nirazim 20, or Lemming smurfing every fight or something, then you can take the Summer Anthem, use it, and then press ult and heal him back to like a third of his HP, so he doesn't get one shot and you can actually use your ult. For the i5, I don't think there is any question, like you just go i5 20, it's really dumb as a talent. Like if you play well, you can be permanently unstoppable. Bossa Nova, it's a really good talent when you're up against, let's say, short cooldown ults that people get at 20, like for example Sylvanas Mind Control, or Lyric Entomb Silence, this kind of stuff. Like you will always have your sound barrier for this. If you don't know what to take, you just take House Party. I mean, I guess that's always good.
When is a good time to pick Lucio, or when is like a bad time?
Before, like, mass CC would be a bit annoying into Lucio, but now that you have i5, Lucio is like almost always good. You kind of see it now in CCL, it's first rotation usually, or second. Against me it's just ban, but that's another thing. But yeah, Lucio is really good in general. The counter picks would be Diablo and Anub, but then again that's not really counter picks, because if you think about it, Diablo always waits for you to do something, but you can just stay in his face and hit him. And the fact that you can interrupt his Apoc combo makes Diablo unplayable into Lucio. Like, it's actually the opposite. And Anub is annoying for the cocoon, but that's about it. You can just maybe trade out. You dash towards your ally, they pop the cocoon out instantly, and then you're good to go. Support-wise, Stukov can be annoying with his level 1 and his silence, especially on the 7, the talent that grows, because you would put the silence between the guy that your team goes on and the Lucio, it would expand and it prevents you from using both sound barrier and the i5. Lucio is pretty solid into offlaners in general. Like, I can't really think of an offlaner that would be annoying. I can think of a range that would be annoying is Chromie. I used to die a lot to that because of the traps, actually. You would just place the traps alongside the wall, and if the Lucio is getting too aggressive, he would just walk into it like 100% of the time. Like, I can guarantee you that if you place your trap next to a wall that's next to you, the Lucio will just skate through it and die.
So on Lucio's team, what do you synergize with the most, right? Like, I mean, you mentioned that Lucio a lot of times is picked, you know, highly. But what kind of draft do you like to build with a Lucio?
Heroes that benefit from the move speed. AA heroes like Greymane, Raynor, Cassia. Same for the tanks like Tyrael and stuff. Offlane, there are a lot of heroes like that, Sonya, like every offlaner that goes in, basically.
How do you approach team fights? Like, are you generally, you know, looking, just waiting for an opportunity to get the backline, or what are you looking to do?
So it would depend, actually. Like, you would mostly stay with your team and hit the front line until you see, like, let's say, an occasion to trade in and queue, like, the tank into your tank so you get CC'd and stuff. You can do that in the backline even, especially with the level 4 quest that I talked about, with the boop range. But with 16, like, you can poke the backline by yourself, or let's say your mage puts someone at like 30% HP, then you can start going around the fight and look to finish the kills. Like, that's totally a thing, especially on people that can't defend themselves. Like, if you go on a Raynor and you don't know if it still has E, maybe it's bad. But let's say it's Lemming, like, you will totally kill a Lemming, that's 30% HP.
So do you kind of have some Lucio tips and tricks for people?
Something that's kind of brand new with the i5 patch. Let's say your teammate is into a Malfruit, and like you have no way to get through him, you can actually ult another teammate, get unstoppable on yourself, and then you can ult that guy that's in the root, and you wouldn't get CC'd that way.
Oh, you can like chain the unstoppables effectively.
Yeah, and at level 20 you can be permanently unstoppable if you play well, because like there is 10 people in the game, I mean I guess 9, but that's fine, because in the end you can be permanently unstoppable if you press ult every 1 second.
Yasu, thank you so much for giving us so much insight into Lucio, the newest 30k CCL member. So hyped to have you on the team. Any kind of shout outs, or you know, where can people find you at?
I usually stream on Twitch during the weekends. It's English and French stream. Sadly, I don't play Lucio in Storm League because it's a bit disgusting, but I play kind of cool heroes like Valyra and stuff that I might play in comp, so feel free to join and say hello.
Thank you, Yasu. Guys, definitely check into our next video. You know, let us know who you want to be. We're going to be interviewing more of the CCL players, getting their insights. So comment in the YouTube section below. What player, what hero do you want to see next? You know, is it an X-Ray playing tank? Is it Dino? I don't know, KT? That would be my option, but you know, we'll see what people end up doing. You know, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Merch is going to be dropping the end of May / early June. Don't have the specific date, but it's going to be coming very soon, guys. Really excited about it. I'd like to take a special moment to say thank you to all the 30K patrons. We really appreciate all your support.